Don't you speak arrogantly? Like I'm better than you? Or I know more than you? Or you've got to listen to me because I've got a degree? That's arrogance. You flatter people for the sake of gaining advantage. Well, if I say this, they'll like me. If you're trying to get people like you, and you flatter them with lies, guess what you're doing? You're impeding the Spirit of God. I can tell you, there's going to be some people don't like me. You know why? There's some folks that didn't like Jesus. You know what? When you live righteous, you're righteous. Even for people who are righteous, but they're not fully righteous, it hurts them because the Holy Spirit convicts them by them looking at your life. Guess what? Just get right, and that'll take care of it. Amen? Amen. You got to make sure that whatever we do, church, it does not, by me or by you, impede the Spirit of God. When we come to that place, this is what happens. There will be a Spirit's awakening in Mill Creek Baptist Church. But until you give your life right, my life is right, our lives are right together, it's not going to happen. Holy Spirit, right now, examine me and let me know the results of that examination. If there's anything I need to confess, show it to me. Lord, for all those in this building today, Holy Spirit, do it. Examination of their life. I pray they all pass, but if they don't, convict them of the sin that's impeding you moving, and let them make it right today so that we can begin to experience the awakening of God in such a way that we know your presence, your power, and your purpose, and Lord, it'll become contagious to this community, to every church in the city of Nashville, and then spread to the state of Tennessee and to the United States and across the world. God, we need this amazing awakening, and we don't want to be the people that impede it. So help us now see ourselves as you see us. Lord, let us not be afraid to let go and to let you, God, take full control. Only when we're under your full control, Lord, will we not impede the Spirit. If we try to hold on to anything that's ours and not surrender everything to you, we're going to impede the Spirit. So, Lord, today, I pray that you work in my life and everybody's life here, that what happens, we let go of everything. It's displeasing to you. And the Spirit from here on out is going to have full force to roam and to change and to do and to bring about awakening, revival, and freshness of life to every believer. I ask that in Jesus' name. Amen. Probably not the sermon you wanted to. Got to do something different. Got to let go of something. Got to make sure that I'm not the kink in the armor that says we're not fully protected from the enemy. We're not the kink in the armor that's fully protected from the enemy. So get it right with God today.
Hello?
Get it right with God today. Please do that. Please do that. Make sure that you get it right with God today, because you may not get it right with God today. If you don't, even though you're my brother and sister in Christ, and you died today, and you stood before God, you'd be hanging your head. I think we all will anyway for a moment, but I'm doing everything I can to be able to look in the eyes of Jesus and him say, welcome. Just, I can reach out and take his hand. I'm not sure I'm going to make it, but I'm doing as best I know how. Amen. Not to envy, not to carouse, not to be drunken. I've never taken a drink, so I'll never get drunk. Except, you know, the Bible says, don't be drunk, be filled with the Spirit. One who's drunk is out of control. That means one who's under control of the Spirit is out of control. I always want to be out of control, under God's control, amen? That's where you need to live, and then you want to feed the Spirit. So whatever the need of your life is right now, it's repentance. Repent and declare your belief and surrender your all to God. If you're lost, God wants to save you today. And I can't promise you tomorrow because the Bible says today, behold, now is a good day of salvation. So you can get saved today. Now listen. You've got an element. Oh, it's an element. Communion was on the piano. We're closer to it now. It's on the communion table. If you need to be made well, if you come in faith, we'll refine the faith. And we'll see how God answers that. Now, one day I may get sick and I ask you to anoint me. And you pray for me to be well. Guess what? If I die, I'm still well because I just went to heaven. I'm perfect. So I can't lose. There's one time God's not going to answer that prayer when he's ready for us to come home. The Bible says that our days were numbered even before we were born. So the day I die, that's when God intended for me to come home. So don't weep at that if you ever get to see it, all right? God's a God. But he does say, for any among you who are sick, let them come and be anointed with oil. Let the elders pray over them. The prayer of a righteous man is going to avail much. That's again what happens when there's an awakening. We're righteous, and we can pray, and we can see God work. Amen. Our hymn of invitation.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Oh, this is God's house. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And be ready to respond to God, not to me. Respond to God with salvation, with repentance.